Good to see you all again here in Berlin. And it's again my pleasure for the 11th time now to welcome all of you to this meeting on NBS or TMS in neurosurgery and neuromodulation.
I think in the future, the rTMS therapy for pain patients will be more common. At the moment, it is already in Finland, it is used in all university hospitals, but I believe that also internationally it will be more common.
We are treating in our Center for Neuromodulation in the Department of Psychiatry in Regensburg patients with depression using the nXTIM TMS device. We can see where we stimulate, so this is completely new to us and it's very important that we see where to stimulate.
While the tractography gives you the anatomy of the white matter connections, TMS gives you the functional information. And by integrating the two, you can then have an anatomo-functional assessment of the individual patient that is important for risk stratification, guide your intraoperative mapping, and of course, it's very important also for patient counseling.
I think that the two methodological pillars of to perform successful TMSCG and reliable TMSCG experiments is first to minimize artifacts due to TMS.
In tinnitus, we have the advantage compared to other neuropsychiatric diseases that we have an immediate response due to an intervention, namely tinnitus loudness changes. And previous studies or a previous study already showed that it is possible to suppress tinnitus via single session rTMS. So what can we conclude from this experiment? That it's possible to personalize rTMS treatment and that it might be a superior approach even if the differences are not significant.
So this leads me to say thank you to all of you for all the great discussions. We will let you know about the next symposium as soon as possible. Thank you very much. Safe travels home.